So welcome to the 7th HPC IODC IO in the Data Center workshop. My name is Julian Kunkel. I am a professor at the University of Göttingen and a co-director at the GWDG in Göttingen, responsible for HPC there. And my co-organizers are Jay.
I'm Jay Lofsett. I'm at Sandia National Laboratories.
I'm Jean-Thomas Quaviva, and I'm a researcher at DDN Europe.
And as usually, this workshop is for me personally one of the highlights in the year, which I will tell you in a moment why that is. This workshop is supported by EasyWays, a center of excellence in simulation of weather and climate in Europe, the Virtual Institute for IO, and the new journal of high performance storage, JHPS. So what is EasyWays? Well, it actually is a project funded by Horizon 2020. It aims to represent the European community for climate modeling and numerical weather simulation. In terms of HPC environments, its goals are to improve efficiency and productivity for the users, support the end-to-end workflow of global Earth system modeling, so that includes climate and weather, and to establish demonstrator simulations that run at highest affordable resolutions. So here you can find the webpage of EasyWays for more information. So the Virtual Institute for IO is a platform for IO enthusiasts for exchanging information. It aims to foster training and collaboration in the field of high performance IO and actually the tracking and deployment of large storage systems. So it hosts, for example, lists for the largest systems in the world. And it helped to bootstrap the IO 500, for instance. Here's the webpage again. So in terms of activities for VI4IO, it started to actually collaborate with the HPC certification forum, which link you find over here, in order to ensure that IO related competencies are properly represented in the skill tree. So what is this HPC certification forum or HPCCF? Well, it aims to standardize the HPC knowledge representation and to establish international certificates that then attest this knowledge. Basically, everyone should be able to do for free and create a certificate for skills that they have mastered. Lastly, it aims to support an ecosystem around the HPC competencies. And second task that we supported last year and this year, it's still an ongoing activity, is that to capture file system specific characteristics, system characteristics that you have in the data center describing your nodes, your storage, and so on. And therefore, we collaborate with the IO 500 such that those characteristics are properly recorded and then can be used to compare different systems. So lastly, the Journal of High Performance Storage that is supporting us, it now has a ESSN number. It's pretty new. It has its first issue published in January this year. I would say it offers a unique set of features. So it has open reviews, that means anyone can provide feedback. We have living papers, that means papers that have been submitted, they can be improved over time. You can have minor or major revisions. It fosters digital replicability of the analysis and the experiments, and it has free open access. There are two pending papers in the incubator that will be soon published in the next issue, but we are always looking for, of course, more, and it's free as an author to publish. Yeah. So now that's why I'm excited is this workshop. And the motivation for this workshop was for us 7 years ago that the IO perspective of the centers is often ignored. That means typically we always look at applications, what can we do to improve them? But the poor sysadmins, the poor data center support stuff, well, what kind of support do they get? Not too much. Data centers, they are so important, however, because they provide the optimal service and performance. But in this kind of goal and this motivation, it's very hard for them because providing a good storage strategy is challenging. You have a lot of storage solutions out there, HPC file systems with pro cons themselves. Then you have to manage these large volumes of and file numbers. Lastly, we have a lot of different middleware that utilizes the file systems and storage systems. and they have different issues and challenges. And then, as the data center must, ultimate goal is to optimize the system, their problem is that they actually lack insight in what the user aims to do. So what are the applications and workflows that run on those systems? So that's challenging, basically trying to work in the dark, like Jay does. But we really struggle to then optimize. So we need to get into the light at some point. So that's why monitoring and analysis is so important, understanding systems and users. If we know everything about the users, potentially, and the applications that run, we could maybe provide a better system. There are various reasons for optimization that I don't read now. The problem is that users often don't know their own I/O patterns and workflows that they are executing. And the I/O stack is, of course, very challenging even for us or even for experts. So the golden was that we had that maybe we thought I/O experts from data centers can make a difference, that we come from individual activities to community efforts and maybe useful conventions. So in this workshop, our goal is to bring together I/O experts from data centers, regardless of file system, to foster information exchange and give you opportunity for networking. I understand that this year it's a little bit more difficult than in other years when we were cramped in these very tiny rooms in ISC in Frankfurt. But nevertheless, I hope that you will use the chat, for example, to exchange information and also the coffee breaks to talk. So topics of interest in this workshop are scientific workloads, usage characteristics in terms of accesses on the file systems or scientific libraries, the system perspective in general, architectures of systems, performance aspects and monitoring, and of course, issues during production and potential solutions. So is there anything, guys, you want to add? Hey, Chintama, why is it matter for you?
Yes, just a few words briefly. So I think also HPC IODC is really about community building, and you will find this into the program. So it's not only about HPC, there is students, there is expert talk, there is research paper. So we try to bring together many stakeholders in the IO world. We are in a small world, so we really need to to be together if we want to have any kind of relevant weight. That would be one point. And the second one, it's related also to the vendor infrastructure aspect. Here, this is really open in the sense that we are not wearing our organization hat. So it's really about exchanging ideas. So that was just my small comment here.
Yeah. The only thing I can add to that is that for me, the unique characteristics of this workshop is really the group discussions. And having that open discussion period is really important and the defining characteristic for me.
Okay, wonderful. So in terms of results of this workshop, we will make the morning presentations for sure available on our webpage, and they will be published in YouTube. We will check with ISC if we can publish the afternoon workshop as well, but it might be more tricky. The research papers that have been published as part of IODC will be published in LNCS, and we offer the authors the chance to submit in JHBS an extended version as well. We also will create a preface and summarize the workshop results published in Springer and then on the webpage. So interactivity is very crucial, as Jay points out. It's a really key part of this workshop, so it's welcomed and expected from the attendees. So put questions, comments in the video chat, or you may raise them verbally at the end of a talk. So we have a couple of discussion time slots. So directly after our first research session, we have a little bit of time. And then we have in the afternoon, of course, more time. It's controlled by a moderator, and we have links to the Google Doc put into these shared notes of this big blue button system. In terms of agenda, we now move into the research session, and then we have an expert talk session, a virtual lunch break, and then we move to ISC HPC Zoom, where we will have a panel discussion, student mentoring sessions, followed by one expert talk, discussion of topics, and that basically is the end.